home right now under a desk because he's still so terrified.
Actually, sheets are pulled over his head. I believe that.
Morgan, if you're listening, it's safe to come out now.
Yeah.
All right. But Claire is here taking care of things.
Yeah, we were texting back and forth. We started hearing reports about it and then, found out it was that space junk falling back to Earth. I'm just bummed that I didn't get to see it myself. But for tonight, now, if it would have happened tonight, we wouldn't have been able to see it. We are looking at a lot more cloud cover this evening. And how about this? The sun sets at 7:31. I don't know about you, but I'm really enjoying these longer days. We haven't quite hit the warmer days just yet. We will next week, though. 51 currently in Seattle, 49 for Tacoma, upper 40s in Port Angeles. We're in the low 50s for Everett, Bremerton, and out towards the coast in the upper 40s. Kyra 7 Pinpoint Storm Tracker this evening, partly to mostly cloudy skies. Now, no rain with these clouds. We typically see these dark gray clouds and we see a lot of rain with it. Not this evening. We have a little bit of a ridge of high pressure over us keeping us dry. But as we head into the rest of the weekend, we're going to start to see some changes for the second half. Kyra 7 Pinpoint Future Track. So for the rest of this evening, here's 10 o'clock. Notice not a lot going on. A few breaks in the clouds. We will see fog filling in for tomorrow morning. So our fog prone locations, watch for that. Throughout the day, a mix of sun and clouds, still dry for Saturday. Here's 11:30 through the afternoon time, maybe a break or two in the clouds, but just kind of a cloudy, mild day. What will change heading into Sunday as our next cold front approaches out towards the coast, pushing in, the winds are going to pick up as well. It's going to be windy, wet, stormy, possible thunderstorms, as well as mountain snow. So we're going to see it all for Sunday through the afternoon time. Again, pushing through, we'll see some thunder and lightning potential, heavier snow Sunday into Monday especially. So looking at the breakdown, the forecast, no major impacts, giving this a zero on the Kyra 7 Pinpoint Storm Tracker scale. For this evening, partly cloudy skies, still no major impacts heading into Saturday. I'm giving this a one, might upgrade it to a two, because if we do see these thunderstorms, we could see hail again. And the gusty winds, especially out towards the coast for Sunday. Now, the good news is once we get past Sunday, we start to see some nicer conditions. By Monday, highs in the low 50s, mostly sunny for Tuesday, getting closer to those 60s by Wednesday and Thursday. Slight chance of showers next Friday.
All right, thanks, Claire. Let's check in now with Margaret Brennan to see what's next on the CBS Evening News.
Good evening, Dave and Monique. Coming up after Cairo 7 News at 6. At least six people are dead tonight after devastating tornadoes sweep through Alabama and Georgia. Dozens of homes destroyed and the South braces for even more storms. Plus, as more Americans get vaccinated against coronavirus, why health officials are still warning of a possible fourth surge. And CBS's Steve Harmon goes on the road. The delicious fundraising idea one son came up with to grant a final wish for his mom. That's tonight on the CBS Evening News.
I was so congested.